Hi, my name is Michelle and I work at the Lawrence Hall of Science and I'm also a parent. This week I wanted to try our I notice, I wonder, it reminds me of routine from our Beetles Outdoor Education curriculum. With everyone staying home, we wanted to give some suggestions about how you might try exploring the outdoors right outside your front door. Or even maybe, if you still can, head to a park. Last week, we sent out a parent guide on how you can use the video to lead the activity out in nature. I linked the parent guide and the video below in the video description. The I notice, I wonder, it reminds me of, I think maybe, activity is so simple with those just four sentence starters, but it can make a really big impact to develop a mindset of curiosity, and it provides language and tools to actively and directly engage with the natural world. Sometimes it helps by practicing all four statements with one object and then mix and match after that, but you don't have to do it in any order. It's really up to you. For me and my kids, we went and explored some moss and we really focused on the moss. But then when we went outside in our neighborhood, we looked at flowers, but we used that same I notice, I wonder, it reminds me of. I notice statements help kids make observations. When you're on walks with your kids, you can encourage them to pick up a natural object, such as a leaf, or in my case, moss, and make an I notice statement out loud with your family. So let's watch an example of I notice.
What do you notice about the moss?
Part of it is furry.
Part of it is furry.
And I don't like that.
So the like is the opinion part, but the furry part is definitely an observation.
There's like lots of fur, like it's like these tiny little things that are like grass, but like furry and a lot smaller, so that when you look at it like just straight up, it looks like little dots on the tree.
Oh, so you notice little dots on the tree. Yeah. I noticed those too.
They have like spikes at the end, but they're not like,
that's a good observation, yeah. These little spikes.
They're not like spiky though. Like spikes. And there's also spikes like on the top. It's pointy on the very tip. Hmm. And there's tiny things that look like spikes on the side.
So that was great. The next one is I wonder. I wonder statements help kids learn how to ask questions. And you might try to encourage kids to ask as many questions as they can about the object for practice, and then ask them specifically about which ones were the most interesting to them that they want to explore further. So let's watch an example of I wonder.
Do you guys wonder anything else?
Do things eat it and what?
Oh, what else eats it? And what, yeah.
Do and what other does things? It use to live?
What is the moss used to live? What else do you wonder about it?
What's it made out of?
What is it made out of? That's a good question.
The next one is, it reminds me of. And this is a way for kids to learn to make connections. It encourages deeper learning. And it can be a connection to something with a similar pattern or something else that they may have experienced in their life. Let's take a look at another example.
What else does it remind you of?
Of my blanket.
Of your blanket? In what way?
It's green and fuzzy.
Green and fuzzy. Oh yeah, your blanket is green and fuzzy. Yeah, let's see. What are you looking at?
It reminds me of mold.
Mold is another interesting thing.
Plus, anyway, there's cool flowers here.
Cool. They're like little lanterns.
Yeah. Yes. They remind me of lanterns.
They remind me of grapes.
Oh, or grapes, sure.
Pink grapes.
Great. Finally, we have I think maybe. This is a way to support kids in learning how to make an explanation, which is an important part of science. This is the taking of observations to the next level by helping kids make an explanation based on their observations. Let's take a look.
It's a lot less mossy in these parts of the forest place, and it could be because there's so many branches. So, but like we found, like almost all of the places where there's a lot of moss, the tree is really damp. But since there's so many branches, it's stopping the water from really getting to the trunks, so that could be why there's a lot less.
We just showed you some examples of doing this outdoors, but we wanted to point out that you can do it indoors too. Look around the house. Maybe you have house plants. Check this example out.
What else do you notice about this?
There's like little stalks and shoots and stuff.
And it grows off of it.
It reminds me of
pandas.
Yeah.
Why does it remind you of pandas?
Because pandas eat bamboo.
Another fun way to use this routine indoors is that you can turn the sound down on a nature video and encourage your kid to do this routine about a nature show.
So here we are looking at a whale fall. Wow, look at that. That's so cool.
Ew.
What do you guys notice?
Octopuses and sharks.
I see a lot of octopuses. That's so crazy. I'm going to pause it and do some noticing.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. Okay. Oh.
Yeah. There's a lot of octopus dudes.
There are a lot of them. I do see.
And there's also and like, they some are inside.
So, oh, I see. I noticed that. Some are inside of the well.
In this routine, you can also use it to notice and wonder and be curious about feelings and thoughts that you might be having, especially during this time that might be really challenging for some children.
All right, so we're here at home and we're going to try to do the I notice, I wonder, it reminds me of routine with thoughts and feelings. Yeah, and so specifically about this situation that we're in right now where we've got the COVID-19 crisis. What do you guys observe about that?
It's terrible.
Is that a observation or is that a
opinion? It's an observation.
Is it? How can you turn it's terrible into an observation instead of an opinion? What are you noticing about?
I observe that it's so bad.
In what ways? Like what's happening?
Yeah,
like,
what's happening? You're stuck at home and you can't really do anything.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, that wraps it up for this video. Thank you for letting me share with you how I adapted the I notice, I wonder, it reminds me of, I think maybe, question routine. We have a longer activity guide and video from our outdoor education curriculum linked in the description below if you want to dive in deeper. We hope you are all staying safe and enjoy this fun activity. We will be back next week with another video sharing how to do nature journaling with your kids. Stay tuned. And if you like this video, please remember to like it and hit subscribe. If you found this content useful, please share our Lawrence at Home playlist with your friends and community so we can support more families.